Hi, my name is Antonio, and welcome to an episode of This Is My Model. Today, I'm joined by Jennifer from CEPSA. Welcome, Jennifer.
Thank you for inviting me, Antonio.
Thank you for being here. So, Jennifer, tell us a little bit about CEPSA.
We are a global, fully integrated company across the entire oil and gas value chain. And since 2018, from the Digital Transformation Department, we are integrating digital technologies into all areas of our business.
Super interesting. So, Jennifer, your team has built an amazing solution for predictive maintenance based on ML. Can you tell us a little bit about this architecture?
In the first stage, sensor data enters on this data platform called NOLAR, which has been developed by CEPSA. Every hour, an event triggers an extent functions, which invokes a set of lambda functions. And in the first part, a lambda takes the configuration from a DynamoDB table, and then another lambda makes a call to a Navi gateway to get the data and pre-process the data, which is then stored in an S3 bucket from which Lookout for Equipment takes the data to make the inference.
Okay, so you're actually using Lookout for Equipment for the ML part of the predictive maintenance. Why specifically you choose that service?
There were two main reasons. The first one is because we were able to quick test the models and we were able to get an idea of the performance. And we also got promising results because we were able to detect anomalies in 2 out of 3 failures. And the second reason is because of the explicability of the models. We get an anomaly and we get a percentage which indicates which sensors are causing the anomaly. So we can use this information to enrich the model output and we can make recommendations to operators. So the model output with the recommendations is stored in an Aurora database from which the visualization platform take the data.
And you are using Fargate for retraining the models, is that right?
Yes, we use Fargate to train and evaluate new models.
Okay, so you're actually connecting there. Fine, so thank you, Jennifer, for sharing those amazing details. Now, what's next?
One of our objectives is making machine learning models accessible to the entire organization. So people without programming skills can create and develop new models. So what we are doing right now is including Lookout for Equipment into NOLAR. So our engineers will be able to train and deploy new models using a graphical interface. Very soon.
That's amazing. Thank you for sharing all those details in this solution, Jennifer.
You're welcome.
And thank you for watching this episode of This Is My Model.